And go.
We are at Crandall Historical Printing Museum.
Tony? Yeah, you're the one that was going to do a bit.
Loans that when you borrow money from the bank, it's a loan.
You guys need to follow Mr. Jim, okay?
Printing.
I will go
home for the
weekend. Well,
sit next to the paper. This is the Johannes Gutenberg Printing Press. What Gutenberg had to do was figure out how to make type. He took and down to make a punch. See, that's a letter. See that letter in there?
Oh, you can see. It's an R.
That's a letter. It's the letter B.
Oh, it's a B?
And it's backwards. That's why you have a hard time.
Yeah.
Because it's backwards. And he made that and used that as a, he put that on a piece of copper and hits it with a hammer, and now he has a mold. That's the mold. Can you see that? That's a letter B. Metal, and pours it in there. But the problem is it goes over the edge, so it's only about that thick. It's too thin to be used for printing. He needs something more like this. So he invented this. This is called a hand type caster. Many historians consider this to be among the most important single inventions in history. Is this what he had to invent to make the printing process possible? He had to hand carve this out of two pieces of soft carbon steel. Notice when I put it together, there's a hole that goes all the way through. So now I take that mold. See, he has a mold of a letter B. I put that in there, clamp it up tight. And this is a spring. I move that spring over into the notch in the back of the mold that holds the mold in place. So now I turn over, the mold is down there with the letter facing up. I can pour the metal in there, it goes down into the mold, and I will end up with something more like this. Then he makes the type we have over here. We have in here the printer's metal, and at 600 degrees it runs just like water. See that?
It's very hot.
Now, that already said that was one solid piece, but this is the way I cast the type. I take and pour the metal in there, and lift it up. I do it so I take a ladle full of metal. Pour it in, I throw for face, and I spilled some there, I shouldn't have. Now I open it up, and there's the metal I just now poured in there. See that? I just now poured that metal in there. This cold steel has absorbed enough that heat that's cooled off enough I can handle it. And there it is with my mold still on top. I take my mold off. And what do I have on the end? I just now cast the letter B. There's excess metal on the end there. I have to break that off. And there's my finished piece of type. I want each one of you to take one to look at it so you see it up close, see what a piece of type looks like. You see that? You see the letter B on the end there?
No, can't see it.
Yeah. Have time to put them all in type case when you use it.
It's amazing. A lot
of patience.
And it becomes liquid again?
Yes, I can just put it back in and remeld it.
Yeah. So what you mean?
He's making it.
It is 80% lead, 13% antimony, and 7% tin. Let me show you here. It's 80% lead. See, that's lead. 13% antimony. This is antimony, it's a metal, and it's 7% tin.
Mm.
Now that combination is important because when it's heated up liquid, as it cools, it expands just a little tiny bit, and that fills on all the fine points of the mold.
It's amazing that he figured all the
You see, good. He was used to working with metals, so he'd take... He invented this little, it's a wooden tray to put the type in. He picks up the type one letter at a time and sets it in there until he has that filled up. That's called a composing stick.
They put each letter.
See how that is?
And that's how you make a sentence.
Now, he filled this up and then he transferred the type from this into this tray. That's called a galley. Till he has this galley clear filled up with type. And once that's clear filled up with the type, then he can begin printing. Okay? In this press. We have set in here 2 pages of the Gutenberg Bible using real Gutenberg type. And every letter, there's an individual piece of type set in there. It's all set in there. You have everything in here to get it all put together.
Sentences together, the Bible.
This is called a chase that holds everything in there. These pieces of wood here is called furniture. The furniture is what positions the type. And these two pieces, and these 3 pieces are wedge shaped. Wide here, narrow here. Wide here, narrow here. And these are what used to tighten everything up and loosen it up. Because you have to have that tight in there, all really tight in there. The next thing we have to do is ink the type. This is printer's ink. See how nice and thick and sticky that is? Gutenberg made this with linseed oil. Boiled linseed oil until it became thick and sticky, and then he added lampblack or soot and lead oxide and copper oxide. Made a beautiful, thick, sticky black ink. So I take that ink and smear it out here on the inking stone like that. Then Gutenberg had to figure out how to get the ink from there just to the surface of the type. He invented these things. These were called ink balls. The ink balls would walk around the ink like this. Get them all covered with ink. And I have to work these for a couple of minutes because I want to get that ink nice and smooth and even over the full face of the ball.
Can you
I don't want any lumps or any bare spots. And then, the way I ink the type, I take these, go like this. I'm going to get a little more ink on there, and it's good enough. You get a little more ink. That's better. Now I can ink the type. Now I can ink the type. Okay. There on that table, get me a blank sheet of paper. We're going to do some printing. See, I can't just put the paper down like that, roll it over, because I can't put every sheet on exactly the same. If I like to print on the reverse side, I've got to line those columns up exactly. And here's the answer to that. You can build a timpan and a frisket. This is the timpan. He built a wooden frame. He covered with animal skin. 2 points here, I put the paper on those, add lines of paper, and pump it down. Line up on a mark on the side for left and right. Now watch this, this is extremely important. Right here are two pins pop through the paper. And when I go to print on the reverse side, I put the paper back on with those through the pins to the same holes, give me perfect alignment front and back. This is the frisket, it's cut out there where I'm going to print. This holds the paper face as I lay it down and lift it up. So it doesn't smear or tear. And I'm going to crank this under. And now, you come and pull a handle. I want you to come around here and get up here on this chair. See if you can reach it there. Let's get the chair a little bit closer. There. Now, I want you to pull and pull and pull. You have to pull real hard.
Don't break it!
Okay. Now, okay, let's get off the chair. And I have to, we only printed half of that, so I'm going to crank this out. See if we can do it. I don't know if he can reach it. He was standing on the chair, but come over and get on the chair. If you can. Can you reach it? Nope. Okay. Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to lift you up. And you get hold of that. And pull and pull and pull. Okay. You got the picture of him?
Okay. Can I check one more time for it?
Okay.
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 Thank you.
Would you listen while I open this up? Do that. See, you two kids just now printed 2 pages of a Gutenberg Bible on a Gutenberg press. You say Gutenberg type, and you did it. See that? You did it. That's great. So you're printers now. That's what Gutenberg printed. A Gutenberg Bible. That's what it looks like.
How long did it take to print the first Bible from start to finish?
Well, I don't know individually, but he printed about 180 copies of that Bible, and it took him about 4 years to. Bible's still in existence, complete Bibles. Still in existence. And this is where they are. Now, there's a lot of individual pages and parts of that are still in existence today. Just a regular.
Oh yeah, was that in English?
He print that Bible as all the characters he had to make. Written by hand. So he had something like this to look at.
The penmanship was amazing.
Yeah, see, that's 5,800 years old. But the one he had was a little larger page. And that's what he used. I've got that blocked right now. And most of the things we have here will tell what it is.
First, the meaning of it, I mentioned that Shakespeare it is to, you know.
I can ask my cousin who. If they know, I'll let you know.
And like I said, I don't know. Yes, this is the press that printed the Declaration of Independence from the United States. Declaration of Independence.
Maybe the original is handwritten. After that, they.
We have set in there the Declaration of Independence. United States was founded. The Declaration of Independence and the Constitution. So, it's the story we tell here.
Was this the Poor Richard? Was it called Poor Richard?
Well, there were other almanacs being printed, and he thought that people thought he was poor and by his, so he named it Poor Richard's.
Poor
Richard's Almanac. And that was this is dated 1733, this one. But.
What kind of information would be in it? Oh, nice catch.
Well, everything they need. See, in the almanac, every page is a month.
Right, it has to do with farming and stuff.
And they have every day in there, and it tells you things like the time of the sunrise,
right,
the sunset,
right.
The phases of the moon.
That's what the farm
is. 2017, this is the current one.
Does it go with the lunar calendar?
See, that's the current one. It's still like the same thing.
Because that's what the farmers rely on
in
Taiwan, yeah.
Well, they dark, you know. And there's only one original handwritten copy. That's the handwritten copy. Why? What they would do, they put it on a stone. They press that original on there and pick it up, roll it, transfer some of that ink.
One of the original.
No, this is a photographic copy.
Okay. I was like, you need to put that on.
It's like our. Sorry, I put your hand.
The extra support.
And then we talk about Ben Franklin and the printing of the Declaration of Independence and Constitution in 1776. And then we tell about printing in 1830 with the printing of the Book of Mormon. And this is the press that printed the Book of Mormon. And you notice it's different. It's cast iron now instead of wood. See, this one was just invented in 1820, so this is brand.
They were able to do a lot of letters.
That's the first 16 pages tight. See that? Wow. See, when Mr. Crandall was setting this up years ago, he had the type all set in place. But he didn't have that piece of wood in there, and so the type was sitting there loose. As he came around like this, the sleeve of his coat caught page 13. He went like that. He dumped.
Wow, that's interesting.
And this is 1830.
Somebody dumped page
13. 30. Pull a handle. Doesn't do any printing, but this makes the type. This was invented in 1886. A man by the name of Omar Mergenthaler. So a name. Up until this, every piece of type was hand cast one letter at a time. This makes type a full letter at a time. I mean a full line at a time.
Our sentence.
Here's one. See that says Crandall Historical Printing Museum. Now the type is upside down and backwards, so it's difficult to read. It says Crandall Historical Printing Museum. And see, that's one solid piece. That's not individual letter. So now, and then when they're finished with this, they throw it back in the pot and remeld it. See, with these individual pieces of type, you use them over and over and over and over and over again. You're not going to use that exact line again, you know, on your other printing. So this isn't any good anymore, so yeah, remeld it and make what you need. This came in 1886. Yes, that's what they called it. And most people called it an acorn press because it's shaped like an acorn. You have to shape like an acorn. Back, try to figure out all the letters. I can't even see the letter. It's so small.
You can see the letters?
In the future, this will be art. The stuff right now.
The letter is small and it's backwards.
Yeah. This is a period, I think. How do you... The letter P.
This is a letter G.
This is a letter O.
This is I.
So what letter? Let's see.
How do you tell... Between a
and that's a problem. It's a big problem. Because when you put...
This is a B.
See the problem with B's and D's and P's and Q's?
This is
B. I know that and they're upside down and backwards.
Right, right.
And on type that small.
Okay.
There's a notch. That tells you which way is facing up.
Got it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So this one has
a knot. Let's find out.
I found a number six.
It's a journal.
That's probably a G.
Yeah.
Nope.
Aw. Letter D?
That's a P, so that'd be a B.
A B?
Upside down and backwards.
So that could be.
See, that's it, so that's. Letter B. That's a larger.
No, I would need it to write down.
See what it's supposed to be, and we'll see what it's supposed to be, and compare.
See if you found.
You should get a kid to come.
This is an R.
Yeah. One more time.
But then put all the B's and P's and D's and Q's.
This is a B.
This is a T.
Like this is called a signature. That's 16 pages. Put in there and you have a notch cut in there. Then you sew them together. You go in that hole, out this hole, around the string, back in the same hole. Out here, around the string, back in that same hole. Come over here, out that hole. Put the next one on, you sew back and forth till they're all sewn together.
Yeah. The books that are sewn, they're so much better.
Yes.
And books are just glued on.
Now, that's interesting because back in those days, you put them in here, lock it up at the front edge, and put them back and forth.
Ah.
Right there is a blade, a very sharp blade, like a razor blade. Go back and forth, it shaves off the top. You take it out. Cut the bottom, again the back and forth, that shaves it off, makes it nice smooth, then you do it at the top.
Right.
Go back and forth, so you end up a nice squared up book block, all folded up.
Cool.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
And then you make a cover, covers a piece of with your hardboard, your binder board on there, and glue it all the way down and all the way around. And you take your book block, put it in there, the end sheets down, the and glue them all the way down. The end sheets are on all the covers of the book. It's all together, and then you decorate the spine. Take gold leaf and a heated rule. It just melts the gold right on.
Nice.
So you have a nice, pretty book block with all the
decorations.
That's such
art, yeah.
Yeah, that's so cool.
Out of horse's hoofs. It's pretty because he went there and shaved that off.
But that's letters being shaved off.
You can touch it.
Yeah. Yep.
Backward and stuff, so when you fold it, you fold it a certain way. Yeah, both sides. So you just fold 16 pages. You take this one once, twice.
You fold it three times.
And then you cut off the edges.
And there's the first 16 pages of the woman. Then when you have, it takes 37 of these, when you get them, then you put them in the book block, and then you put them in there, and shaves off that, open up the blades.
Cool.
Shaves that off, and
when
opens
up after
all
they bind
folds.
All that together, then they shave it off before they glue the covers on.
Yeah. That one, use a saw, make the cuts. Back fold. A lot of things are from people that, you know, they're in the businesses. And they call in and make an appointment because I don't want that.
Right. Thank you.
This is the press of print, the first Deseret News, the first newspaper in the Intermountain West in 1830. Or 1850, I'm sorry. 1850. And everything is still the same. Except the press is cast iron, a little smaller. Other than that, everything is the same. Told you how Gutenberg made his type by hand filing out the punch. How would you like to hand file a punch and type that size?
It's tiny.
Yeah, that is tiny.
Can you imagine hand filing that?
Okay. Yeah.
I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
News nowadays. Of course, that's when things I'd like to point out as Rant News looked like. June 15th, 1850, volume one, number one. And the front page news hasn't changed at all. It says the front page news, there's a fire, a big fire's burning in California. The U.S. Senate's locked up in a debate.
So same thing.
June 15th, 1850, Deseret News. So the U.S. Senate's locked up in a debate. They're still debating.
Yep.
Wait, what?
There's a fire burning California, and the U.S. Senate's locked up in a debate.
That's so funny. That's, yeah.
Let you know, but it's pretty ancient Chinese.
Okay,
that is helpful.
I take your word for it.
And what's it called? Can't read this. Because it's like all by, the date is like by the dynasty. So I don't.
Mr. Crandall, he's the one that started. Mr. Crandall died in September. This is funeral program.